Anton here from Perth Gardens, and I'm here at the scene of a fuel spill. I don't know if you can see that. Forgot my funnel. Had to get fuel unleaded from the jerry tank into this little thing. Mix up my two-stroke for the day. And unfortunately, you know, that's something that happens. This spills happen. And not only that, you know, I've got to lift this heavy jerry can on my own and hold it in the air while trying to transfer it into this little can here. Pain in the ass. But that's going to all be over very soon. This is really bad for the environment, right? You know, if you think about how many people are doing this every day. I heard somewhere that that this is like an oil tanker worth of fuel is spilled every year in America, just from garden equipment, just from doing stuff like this, filling up the cans, and then transferring that to the garden equipment. So it's very bad. However, it's ending. It's ending for me. I've already done videos reviewing some of my my Ego battery powered tools, and you can see some of them here. I've got my lawnmower, got my brush cutter in here. I've got my multi-tool with a lawn edger attachment and a brush cutter attachment and a pole hedge trimmer. Then in my toolbox here, let's open that up. Get some of the stuff out of the way. Got a blower, hedge trimmer. Tucked in the back, I've got a pole chainsaw. So all sorts of stuff. And there's my batteries up the top there. The exciting thing that's happening now is I've set up solar charging. This is really cool, I reckon. So I want to go through some of the details about this solar charging setup I've got going on here. So with this now, you can hear in the background over there, you can probably hear a petrol blower being used at the moment by my mate who's cleaning some gutters. That is the last of the petrol tools being used, and that is about to be put away for good, because I've just set this up yesterday and I will now have my fully mobile battery powered zero emission setup with me at all times. So let me tell you about that. Let me tell you how it works. I've got the 120 watt solar panel on the top. Comes through into the toolbox to a charge controller. Now the point of this is to regulate the voltage that goes through into this battery, which I'll show you in just a moment. If the voltage drops too low, say the solar panel goes into shade or it's nighttime or something like that, then a solar panel can actually start to discharge the battery. So this will stop that from happening. It disconnects the battery from the solar panel when there's insufficient voltage coming through to charge the battery. So inside the battery box, mounted that up nicely on top of the battery box. Inside the battery box, we have a big Deep Cycle battery. That's a 120 amp hour battery. And then from there, that feeds into a power inverter. So back to the battery for a moment. Point of the battery is we have a 120 watt solar panel on the roof, 120 watts is not enough to run these battery chargers or any of the tools that I use. So we charge a battery, and then the battery stores a whole lot more energy than the solar panels can provide at any moment in time. And then we can fill the battery up slowly and then draw it down fast by sucking it out as needed. Now, you can take 12 volt power directly from the battery or through this charge controller here, but I'm not using any 12 volt tools or equipment here. But if you wanted, you could run camping fridge or things that plug into a cigarette lighter, that kind of thing. But I've specifically set this up to run this power inverter here, which converts the 12 volt power from the battery into 240 volts, which I can use for my chargers. And so in the back there, I've got regular power leads plugged in, and that goes to my Ego chargers. There's the rapid charger, there's the regular charger. I keep spare batteries up here, as you can see. And so if I start the day with all my batteries charged, as soon as one's used up, I chuck it onto a charger, and it keeps me going throughout the day, and I never need to run out of power. I carry about 6 batteries with me. So that's my mobile solar charging setup, and I'm really pleased with it. I reckon it's awesome. It's practical. It, apart from all of the other benefits, it lets me just keep my tools charged while I'm on the road without having to bother with getting power from the clients or carry around petrol like I had to do with the petrol tools. And it lets me tell people genuinely that I've got a 100% zero emissions gardening service. It's let me complete the journey which I started a year ago when I bought my first couple of battery powered garden tools, and complete that, so that now I've from start to finish it's all environmentally friendly, zero emissions, and that's really cool. So now I've got the full set of gardening equipment and my mobile charging set up. The benefits of this, there's cost benefits as well. I'm not sure whether the having the solar panel is going to actually save me any money in itself, because there's a bit of cost involved in setting it up and getting all those components. So chances are it's probably not going to save me any money. If you took the solar out of the equation, battery power tools are definitely, you're financially better off having them than petrol tools. Even taking into account things like batteries having a lifespan and needing replacing every few years or something, they're still, by my rough calculations, it's still sort of half the price per hour of usage as petrol tools, and other people say it's even better value than that. That for me is not a major factor in deciding to go down this route, but it's a bonus, and I think if you're doing hundreds of hours of use of powered equipment, then those savings are probably worthwhile. So financial benefits. It's very practical, this setup. There's less maintenance of the tools, and I talk about that in the different review videos that I do, so I won't go into that now, but just being able to grab a tool, slot a battery in, squeeze the trigger, and you're in action. That's great. That's really good when you're just trying to get stuff done. For me, as I said, the biggest factors were in deciding to go down this route are environmental, and I think it's important that we make these changes for the sake of the environment and, you know, climate change and all of that. But that's not something that I'm not sure that that's been a massive selling point for me in terms of marketing this to clients. Works for me though. What is a good selling point in terms of pitching this kind of service to clients is the low noise aspect of it. And you know, at the same time as you've got no pollution, you've also got no noise pollution, and that's really good. You know, when I'm working out in the hills, you know, at the moment that you can probably hear behind me, as compared to before when I did the first part of this video, there's no power tools going on in the background, and you probably can't hear it, but all I can hear is just, you know, the birds chirping and the wind in the trees, and that's how I reckon it should be out here. But you know, we have clients who have businesses, and we can work on their premises without disrupting their business or their clients. We can go to houses early in the morning, 6:30 in the morning, and start work, which is great in summer when it's really hot. And we don't have to worry about waking people up or disturbing the neighborhood. So all those noise factors are really good with the battery operated tools. So yeah, look, I hope showing you what I've done with my setup here, the solar power and everything, I hope that inspires some other gardeners to make these changes. You don't have to go the whole route of solar charging and everything, but there's even just getting some battery powered tools, I think you'll find very beneficial, and it's just good all around with very little downside. You know, once you've figured out how to manage your the batteries so that that's not an issue and you're not worried about running out of power, then there really isn't any downside. There's no reason not to make the change to battery powered tools. Okay, so I'll catch you later. I've got another review coming soon.